Multimeters, or multimeters, are an incredibly useful tool for electronics and anything. If you're doing stuff around the house, you just need to know how to use them. They are very useful, but you can also hurt yourself, kill yourself. So we're going to go over really quick how to use it properly, what to look for, and how not to kill yourself. So first things first, I have here a desktop multimeter, or multimeter. I'm more comfortable with multimeter, but you'll hear it both ways. And then I also have this one that I use all around the house whenever I'm doing an electrical project because it's just very easy. Now, both of these can do different things. I mean, they obviously have their pros and their cons, but for right now, we're going to focus on their most basic features and just not really worry about it too much. The three things that we'd like to talk about today are checking the resistance, checking the voltage, and checking the current. One thing that I use for electronics specifically quite a bit is I'm colorblind, and I also am terrible at memorizing the color code stuff on resistors. So if I have a resistor just laying there, I don't do well with saying, oh, okay, that is... Yeah, I literally have no idea what colors those are. But I do have a multimeter, and I can just use it, touch both ends, and it says 90K, but I'm also touching it, so I'm throwing things off. So now it's saying exactly 100 kilo-ohms. So the way I have this is I've turned it on, obviously, and then I have what looks like the horseshoe, the ohm symbol right there. And with that, you can just go and you can check anything rather easily, and whoosh, right there, 100 kilo-ohms. I can do the same thing with this, and I will see 100.079. So this is actually 100,080 ohms. So this one, being a more expensive, even better, more precise multimeter, it can show that it's not exactly 100 kilo ohms, but it's actually 80 ohms over, which this is a 5% resistor, so we're expecting some variation. That actually shows a really good thing that you do need to think about when you are doing testing, because even though we like to think of ourselves as not causing any sort of change in resistance, me just touching the two leads, the resistance in my body changes it. So you can see it's down to like 98, 97. And again, I did the same thing. And now even just putting both of them together, it causes all sorts of confusion. So remember that the multimeter and your body will change things. So keep that in mind. So resistance, very useful. Only useful with resistors though. Does not work with capacitors, does not work with inductors, also doesn't work with powered circuits. So you only want things that are unpowered and isolated, and that doesn't necessarily mean that you can't use it on your circuit boards. Even when things are going all around, it might be helpful to say, what's going on here? I want to check my resistance from one point to another, and you'll notice that there are some parasitics that you didn't plan for. So you can use this with any part that is in a circuit, but just know that it's going to be confusing, and that doesn't necessarily mean the part you are measuring has that resistance. So since it's a multimeter and it does lots of things, we can also check the voltage. Now this is where things get tricky. Now if you notice, there's four holes down here, and it says 10 amps, microamps, milliamps, common, and then voltage. So when I'm checking voltage, I need to make sure I'm in this, because when you're checking voltage, you want a very high impedance. You want your multimeter to be very high impedance so that you don't have current flowing through it. So if I were to be plugged into the amp right now and I were to go over this, let me power up this circuit really quick. Okay, so I just put 6 volts over this resistor. So now with my multimeter in voltage mode, I go and making sure not to touch it so I don't throw it off, and I'm measuring 5.93 volts, which makes sense. Now the way this works is when it's measuring voltage, the impedance that the circuit sees from this is almost infinity. That as close as possible. Obviously it's not, which is where you get some weird variations, but you want your impedance to be nearly infinity. However, as soon as you put this over to the microamp, milliamp, or the 10 amp area, it drops its internal impedance to almost zero. So if I had this lead connected in here and then did this same thing, I would blow the fuse at best. Might melt some leads. And this is actually why they tell you to never put these into an electrical outlet, because if you don't know what you're doing and you're plugged into the amps, you will melt these and you'll blow the fuse and you might cause a fire. And my older brother did that when I was a kid and it scared the pants off of me. And it took me a long time to be okay with, okay, when I'm properly set up, I can put this in the electrical outlet to make sure that I have power or don't have power. But if you are not certain and you're not confident, don't do it. But if you take your time, you think, you double check everything, okay, I can do this, you can plug these into the electrical outlet and see exactly what voltage you get. Right now, I'm actually set up for DC, so you wouldn't see anything because your electrical outlet is AC, but that's neither here nor there. So I'm actually going to change this really quick and show you how we would measure current. So right now, as you saw, I measured the voltage across the resistor, and now we are going to figure out how to measure the current through the resistor. So I'm going to set that up really quick. Okay, so I just set it up, so now we are going to measure current. Knowing that I'm giving it 6 volts and that this is a 100 kilo ohm resistor, I was anticipating it to be about 60 microamps. So that's why I put this in the microamp area, and that gives it so we can see down there. Now, if we had put in a 10 amp, it just changes the range and you probably wouldn't have seen anything. But if you do 10, like a couple of amps through this, again, you might blow the fuse because it's not set up to measure large currents. So you always want to calculate it beforehand, before you plug things in, to know what you're expecting to read. So now I have it set up so it comes from the power supply, goes through the positive lead, through the multimeter, and again, we're expecting the impedance of the multimeter to be about 0, and then it's going to come out the negative lead. I'm going to touch it to this side of the resistor, and then it'll go through the resistor, and then back to the power supply. So again, instead of being in parallel with the power supply to measure for voltage, we need to be in series to measure for current. And now I'm just going to go and touch this, and you can see 59.4 microamps. So very close to what we were anticipating, and actually seeing as how we measured just shy of 6 volts, that's spot on. So exactly what we were expecting. And that's it, really. That's all you need to know to measure resistance, voltage. Again, make sure with voltage you have it set up right. And even more importantly, when you're measuring current, don't put it into the electrical outlet. I never store my multimeters with it plugged in this, just in case I'm not paying attention next time. So right now, I'll just say, all right, I'm done with this. I'm going to power this down. I'm going to pull this out and put it over here so I have high impedance, just in case next time when I come to use this multimeter, I don't kill myself or melt things, cause a fire. So I hope that was helpful and also interesting. If you have any questions or comments, leave it in the section below as it is. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and like this video.